Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. I am Vivek and today I'm going to share questions and answers for MS-900, Microsoft 365 Fundamentals. The passing score for this exam is 700 out of 1000 and the exam fee depends on the country where you live. I'm based in UK, so the exam fee is £69. Now, let's get started with our questions and answers. Question number 1. Match each Microsoft 365 feature to its availability. On the left side, we have the features. On the right side, we have the availability where we need to choose the correct feature. The first option is can be turned on for evaluation. The correct feature is public preview. The second option is available to specific customers. The correct feature is private preview. The third option is compliance testing completed. The correct feature is private preview. The fourth option is available for purchase. The correct feature is general availability. Question number 2. You are a Microsoft 365 administrator for a company. You use products that are in private preview, public preview, or general availability. You need to determine at which phases you can receive support from the Microsoft 365 Admin Center. For which product phase or phases can you receive support? Option A, GA, private preview, and public preview. Option B, GA and private preview only. Option C, GA only. Option D, GA and public preview only. Option E, public preview and private preview only. The correct answer is option C, GA only. Question number 3. You are the Microsoft 365 administrator for a company. Which release type are used for each deployment scenario? Match each deployment scenario to its appropriate release type. On the left side, you have the deployment scenarios. On the right side, you have the release type and you need to choose the correct deployment scenario. The first release type is private release. The correct deployment scenario is limited deployment for a small number of organization for a short duration. The second release type is public preview. The correct deployment scenario is limited deployment for short duration. The third release type is general availability. The correct deployment scenario is widespread deployment. Question number 4. A company has a Microsoft 365 subscription and a Microsoft Azure support plan. You need to implement only Azure services for which Microsoft provides technical support. Which two types of services and features can you implement? Option A, general availability. Option B, targeted release. Option C, public preview. Option D, private preview. The correct answers are option A, general availability. Option C, public preview. Question number 5. You are the Microsoft 365 administrator for a company. The company supports an aggressive rollout of features. You need to release features as soon as they are released. Which feature phase should you use for each deployment step? On the left side, you have the feature phases. On the right side, you have the development step and you need to choose the correct feature phase. The first development step is complete compliance testing. The correct feature phase is private preview. The second development step is complete QA testing for recently released feature. The correct feature phase is public preview. The third development step is prepare QA result and end user documentation. The correct feature phase is general availability. Question number 6. You are a Microsoft 365 administrator for a company. Microsoft plans to release a new feature for Microsoft Excel. You need to ensure that the feature becomes available for employees to install as soon as possible. To which release channel should you subscribe? Option A, Microsoft Release. Option B, Standard Release. Option C, Office 365 Team Release. Option D, Targeted Release. The correct answer is Option D, Targeted Release. Question number 7. You are the Microsoft Office 365 administrator for a company. You need to perform security and compliance review before updates are distributed to the entire company. What should you implement? Option A, standard releases. Option B, Microsoft 365 Enterprise Test Lab. Option C, targeted release. Option D, fast track. The correct answer is Option C, targeted release. Question number 8. You are the Microsoft 365 administrator for a company. Users in the IT department must receive new Office 365 preview feature before the features are deployed to other users in the company. You need to ensure only the users in the IT department receive preview features. Which two actions should you perform? Option A, instruct users to navigate to insider.office.com and sign up for Office Insider. Option B, instruct users to update Office Pro Plus. Option C, in the organizational profile, state the update preference to targeted release for selected users. Option D, instruct users to uninstall Office Pro Plus and then reinstall the software. Option E, in the organizational profile, set the update preference to standard release. The correct answers are Option A, instruct users to navigate to insider.office.com and sign up for Office Insider. Option C, in the organizational profile, set the update preference to targeted release for selected users. Question number 9. You need to ensure that all users in your tenant have access to the earliest release of updates in Microsoft 365. Which organizational release option should you use? Use the targeted release for entire organization, standard release, targeted release for selected user, first release. The correct option is targeted release for entire organization. Question number 10. For each of the following statement, select yes if the statement is true, otherwise select no. The first statement is, by default, all Microsoft 365 subscribers are configured for targeted release. The correct answer is no. The second statement is, to enable or disable targeted release in an organization, select each user who should receive early access to feature and functionality from a list. The correct answer is Yes. The third statement is to enable Microsoft Office Insider release in an organization, select each user who should receive preview access to features and functionality from a list. The correct answer is no.